One of our community members thought it would be a nice challenge for us to create a pineapple logo. Let's get on Canva and use our shapes to create this pineapple logo and convert it to 3D using Photopea. Access www.canva.com and then open a blank logo canvas. Step number one of our process, we're going to create the crown part of the pineapple. So you're going to add a circle on your logo canvas, and then you're going to change color and make it green. Next, duplicate the shape and make it white. Size it on the green shape so that it starts creating that jagged piece of crown that we're busy designing. Next, group the two shapes and then duplicate them and add them and layer them on top of each other to create the right hand side of your crown. Next, you're going to download this and create a PNG file. So you're going to go to share and download, and then jump into remove.bg to remove the white shapes that we've added on our design. After downloading your PNG from remove.bg, you're going to jump back to Canva, and then you're going to delete the shapes that we've created and then upload the PNG file that we've downloaded. Next, you're going to crop out an extra space around the crown that we've created, and then duplicate the image to have the left-hand side of your crown. Flip horizontally and then align the two images next to each other so that it reflects a crown. And then group them so that they are one shape, and then crop them so that they take away the extras at the bottom to reflect your crown. Next, head over to your elements and search for an oval shape. Once you found the oval shape, change the color and make it an orange, you know, the pineapple color. Select that and change the color to orange. Align the oval shape on your crown and make sure that it fits nicely. And then select your oval shape and click on position to open up your layers. Make sure that the oval shape is below the crown so that it's at the back of your crown. Your pineapple is almost done. Now the fun begins. You're going to press L to add a line on your shapes. Select the dots of the lines and then reduce your line weight to A1. Reduce the line size so that it would fit our pineapple, and then align it in a vertical format on top of the pineapple so that it creates those pineapple squares that we would like. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through. I just gotta get through, I just gotta get through. Cause I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. I know the time can heal it all, I just gotta get through. I just gotta get through. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. Last thing to do is to change the color of our line and make it white, because we would like to have gaps when we convert this to a 3D. I really don't like that small white line that I see in the middle of the crown. So I'm going to press L for a line and add the green line in between the so that it looks nice and clean and seamless. Next, I would put my pineapple on the side and press T for text and add the company name. So I'm going to be using a home pot display font, and I would write the name of the company, love to create a design for this name just to make things interesting for our design logo. I will change the color and make it green, and I'll press C for circle to add a circle just to create that nice design over there. Create an ovaly shape of a circle. Tilt it to the side because we're gonna align it and add it to the name, and then change the color and make that white. And duplicate that, change that and make that orange. And then take the white and place it on top of the name. Don't worry if you don't see it, you can just go to your layers and then go look for it there, like we're gonna do. We're gonna go to our three dots and we're gonna go to position, and we're gonna go to layers, and then you're gonna move it just to be above the name so that it just overlaps on top of the name like we are seeing now. And then move the second one and add it on top. We've created the nice gap over there. And then we're gonna duplicate this and change it to white. Then overlap it to create a cushion of some sort, like that. Just for fun design. Then you can align it and bring it a little bit up. Like that, your pineapple zone logo is done and dusted. Okay, we're gonna download it as a transparent background and then convert it to 3D. So I'm gonna go to my share and download it as a transparent background. Take note, Canva has taken away the functionality that we had when we've added whiteness to remove those as background. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna go to remove.bg, drop our design over there and take off the extra space, download that, and then access photopea.com and then open a template, and you pick a logo mock-up template that you want to use. Once it opens up, you're going to double click where it says your logo here, and you're gonna hide the example. You're gonna click and drag your 2D downloaded design, size it and make it nice and big. Press Command S or Control S and then click on the first tab to convert it to 3D. You're then going to export it as a file that you want to use. So you're gonna go File and Export as a PNG, a JPEG, SVG, it depends on where you need to send the file to. I'm gonna export it as a PNG. If you don't want the pixelation, you can reduce the width, or you can export it as an SVG. It doesn't pixelate, it converts it to a vector. Then you click on save, and you need to let me know on the comments below your comments on this cute little logo that we did on Canva, very quick and easy. I do enjoy these creative sessions we have together. Thank you so much for joining me. If you want to go and learn another shapes logo, go to our shapes playlist and have lots of fun there. I will see you on the next video.